Let us think of magnetostriction. What is meant by magnetostriction? Actually, many interviews, they will ask this question. Okay, means what they will ask, like if you go adjacent to the transformer, of physical transformer, it will give a humming sound like that. Okay, it will give a humming sound. Why that is giving sound? They will ask. Okay, that is because of magnetostriction. So let us think of what is meant by magnetostriction. Three stars. Okay, basically one thing I'll tell you, how noise come, for example, this is solid, okay, sound will come. Okay, if I do like this, sound will come. Why that noise came? Because of two things. What are those? The moment I hit this, it is vibrating. Okay, so those vibrations traveled through air and I'm able to hear that noise. And second condition is, it vibrated fine and it should be in the audible range for human being. Audible range of frequencies for human being will be 20 Hz to 20 kHz in our 8th standard or maybe 9th standard we studied. Okay, so if anything is in the audible range, if anything is vibrating with the audible range, means we will be able to hear the noise. Okay, similarly now means my magnetic core is going to vibrate. How it is going to vibrate? Let us see. For example, maybe if I think of the nucleus here, okay, at starting under unmagnetized state of magnetic material, means all my dipoles are randomly positioned. Okay, orbits are randomly positioned. For example, gradually one orbit is aligned. After that, another orbit is aligned. After that, another orbit is aligned. After that, another orbit is aligned. So, once you go into deep saturation, almost all the dipoles are aligned. Means perfect. Okay, if all the dipoles are aligned, under that condition, how my atom will be? At the center, nucleus will be there. Means one dipole, second dipole, third dipole or third orbit, one orbit, second orbit, third orbit, fourth orbit, all orbits should be on this plane only, such that all orbits will give you orbital polarization in this direction. Okay, for example, at starting means my positive charge is like this, negative charge may rotate in this direction, in this direction, in this direction, in this direction. Okay, now after that, all will be aligned to one plane because of saturation, deep saturation. Okay, now for example, you can compare this with your classroom, okay, in your engineering college or anywhere. Okay, for example, if all the students are aligned towards faculty, like for example, in a room, I can allocate 50 members, for example. Okay, if all those 50 members are randomly sitting, one guy viewing the other side, another guy is viewing the other side, another guy is viewing the other side, one guy is seeing to the faculty, under that condition, that same room may not be sufficient for 50 members. Logic is simple. Okay, so point here is very simple. A nucleus will be there when all orbits are randomly positioned, under that conditions, my linear dimensions of the core, because all are randomly positioned, linear dimensions of the core will be more. Now, for example, gradually another orbit is aligned. So the moment all orbits are maximum orbits or whatever it may be, depending upon magnetization, when orbits aligned, not only for this atom, adjacent atom also orbits will be aligned, top atom also orbits will be aligned, bottom atom also orbits will be aligned, because of that my material shrink. This is called as magnetostriction. For example, see here, in a means diagrammatical way, if I show, okay, so for example, means all my magnetic dipoles are in different directions, okay. Okay, so under that condition, if you think of length of the material L, linear dimensions. Now, if you apply some electrical current upon this, Okay, so let me use red color. This is going to be electrical current. Now, because of this, my flux should be in this direction. Now, by right hand thumb rule, my current is flowing in this direction, flux will be in this direction. So, because of that, all dipoles will be aligned in this direction. Okay, if all dipoles align in this direction, okay, under that condition, my length of the material will be shrinked to L minus delta L. Okay, is called as magnetostriction. For example, okay, means let me supply sinusoidal current. If I supply sinusoidal current, what will happen? For example, I am supplying sinusoidal current, or maybe the AC current, okay, alternating current. Under that condition, what will happen? All the dipoles, or at least most of the dipoles, are aligned in one direction. After that, D aligned in another direction. Okay, so for example, once they are D-aligned like black, D-aligned. Okay, under that condition, L. Now, once all dipoles are aligned in this direction, L minus delta L. Again, D-aligned, L. Again, aligned in opposite direction, L minus delta L. Means simple logic. Okay, if 50 students are aligned towards me, whatever may be the space requirement, if all 50 students are aligned opposite to my direction also, the space is sufficient. But if all the 50 students are randomly positioned, under that condition, the space requirement is more. Okay, so if all dipoles are aligned in this direction, or if all dipoles are aligned in this direction, okay, if all dipoles are aligned in this direction, it is going to be L minus delta L only. Okay, but if all the dipoles are de-aligned completely, under that conditions, length will be more. Okay, now for example, if I supply 50 Hz frequency means my vibration frequency will be what? My vibration frequency will be 100 Hz. Why? For example, if I think of one cycle of excitation, under that condition, means all the dipoles are de-aligned. L minus delta L. Okay, so zero, positive max, zero, negative max, zero, in the sense L minus delta L. Okay, so for one cycle here, two times vibrations will come. So the frequency of vibrations, if you see, the frequency of vibrations of the material is going to be with the double the frequency of excitation. So I can write as frequency of magnetostriction are directly humming. Frequency of hum is going to be two times frequency of excitation. Now, if frequency of excitation or frequency of input voltage is 50 Hz, for example, my frequency of this vibration is going to be 100 Hz. So, 100 Hz is in our audible range of 20 Hz to 20 kHz. So, within 100, means the moment my transformer core is vibrating with 100 Hz, we will be able to hear the noise. That is called as humming. Okay, so humming in transformer is because of magnetostriction. Now let us define magnetostriction. What is magnetostriction? Very simple. Linear dimensional variations of magnetic material due to magnetization is nothing but magnetostriction. Let me repeat again. Okay, linear dimensional variations of magnetic material. Okay, linear dimensional variations of magnetic material due to magnetization is nothing but magnetostriction, and humming is because of magnetostriction. Okay, now I'm leaving this topic. Okay, means this particular magnetic material modeling is completed. Okay, of course we have to come back in order to model hysteresis loss again. Anyway, I don't want to extend this because already we spent much time, okay, in understanding nonlinearity, in understanding harmonics, okay, and in understanding why harmonics need not be considered in single phase transformer, harmonics in currents especially, Okay, why harmonics cannot be there in operating flux? So we spent much time here. So I don't want to continue the same more. Now immediately after this, I'm going to stop the modeling of magnetic material. Immediately we'll start maybe modeling of other things, maybe eddy currents. After that we'll come back again. We'll start this such that we'll get a means, like multiple times, if you have hands-on experience, we'll get the grip and we will remember the things properly. Okay.